Hello dear students, so today we are going to discuss the remaining topics of chapter 7b, that is the study of the compound ammonia. So today we are going to discuss about the combustibility of ammonia gas. So ammonia is neither combustible and it is nor a supporter of combustion. So its reaction with oxygen. So when ammonia burns in atmosphere of oxygen, it will undergo catalytic oxidation. So first we will study about the burning of ammonia in oxygen. So here you can see when ammonia it react with oxygen, it will give nitrogen and water. Okay, so this is the procedure. You have to pass dry ammonia gas through tube A. Through tube A, this tube A, we will pass dry ammonia gas and then we will ignite the gas at nozzle and X. From here we will ignite the tube. Okay, then we will pass oxygen gas from tube B and then we will again reignite the ammonia gas at the nozzle and X. Then what will be the observation? We will see when dry ammonia gas passed through the ignition tube A, when the dry ammonia gas was passed through this tube and ignited, it does not burn. In that case, it will not burn. But when we will pass oxygen, ammonia burns in an atmosphere of excess oxygen with a greenish or greenish yellow flame. Okay, so when we will pass oxygen, in the presence of oxygen, ammonia burns with green or greenish yellow flame. Okay, so it means ammonia reacts with oxygen and then in that case it will give nitrogen and water. So this is the burning of ammonia and oxygen. Now next is the catalytic oxidation of ammonia. So here the reaction is when ammonia and NH3 react with oxygen in the presence of platinum and temperature, that is 800 degrees Celsius, it will give nitric oxide and steam and heat. It means it is an exothermic reaction. So it is starting reaction for Ostwald's process, that is the manufacture of nitric acid. Okay, so the manufacture of nitric acid is carried out by Ostwald's process. Okay, so what is the procedure here? You have to pass dry ammonia gas and oxygen gas through inlets A and B. So from inlet A we will pass dry ammonia and from inlet B we will pass oxygen in the ratio 1:2. Then this ammonia and oxygen mixture will pass over heated platinum, which is placed in the combustion tube, which in the heated state emit a reddish glow. Okay, so here ammonia is kept in the combustion tube when it is heated and that time it will emit a reddish glow. So ammonia here acts like a catalyst. Now what is the observation? The colorless nitric oxide is formed on oxidation. Okay, and it will give a reddish brown nitrogen dioxide in the flask. So when it is oxidized, means when it is react, nitric oxide react with oxygen, it will form nitrogen dioxide and that time it will give a reddish brown color. Okay, so that reddish brown color is an indication for nitrogen dioxide. See this reaction, when nitric oxide react with oxygen, it will form nitrogen dioxide and the platinum continues to glow even after the heating is discontinued. Means if we will stop heating it, even after that the platinum will continue to glow. It means that the catalytic, it is because of the catalytic oxidation of ammonia and it indicates that the reaction is an exothermic reaction. So this is the catalytic oxidation of ammonia.